Ooh, it's a good day to have a good day.
It's 1 degree. It's 5:45 in the morning. I wouldn't normally wake up at this time on the weekend, don't worry, but I'm going to an event and I'm going to my mum's home today. I thought I could run to the event. However, it's so cold that I figured I might as well show you how I dress when it's cold, because I feel like that's one of my most asked questions. It's really not that complicated. First things first. Ugh, I have these leggings. Christ, it's cold, but there's no point in me turning on the heating. These are my leggings. They are called the Fast and Free. They're from Lululemon. And they've got big old pockets inside. I'd normally be a little bit more nervous going to an influencer event, but this one revolves around running. And we all know that's my bag. Just any old bra. I'm gonna wear this long sleeve t-shirt from Lululemon. It's called the Swiftly Tech, and I'd highly recommend this t-shirt. It's such a good technical t-shirt. It dries super quickly. It's just honestly, it's like my favorite piece of running kit. I would normally wear a second layer in between my jacket, but I'm gonna be wearing a backpack today, so I think that will keep me warm enough. This is from Lululemon though. I'm going to a New Balance event, so obviously, New Balance jacket, and it's like fleecy on the inside and then a wind cheater on the outside. You should know me well enough by now to know that I'm not fixing this. It's too early. This is from Lululemon. Gloves. But before we put these on,
okay, I've never used this before. This is from Stott, it got gifted, but it's basically like a commuter's rucksack and it fits so much stuff in it. And then I'm hoping this stuff does me for one night.
I'm honestly surprised I'm this awake.
I don't feel that tired. I'm definitely just running on adrenaline. And clothes for tomorrow, because I'm literally just spending the night at my mum's house and I have to come back because I've got work to do in London tomorrow as well. Toiletries. I don't actually have like a cute little toiletry bag. I do need to invest. Crystal Hefner wrote a book. I'm pretty sure it gets published in January, so you will get to read it. I'm gonna start this on the train home. Purse, always. Laptop charger.
It's got these little side pockets as well. It was really difficult with one hand.
Last minute grab. These will come in handy when I'm editing at my mum's. And then my thoughts are, you know, I said that I would normally wear a second layer in between. That actually carrying this is probably gonna keep me quite warm. But yeah, in 0 degrees, you definitely need layers.
This can't be interesting. This is what I look like when I run, by the way, in case you're confused. Don't be bored. I know this isn't riveting content, but I need to know where I've left the keys, okay?
People keep looking at me like I'm an idiot, but that might have something to do with the fact that I'm running down Oxford Street looking like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. It's a Luke. Look at it. I just love that you don't really get to see Oxford Circus like this unless you run. You truly get to see a part of the world that not many people do. When I post this video tomorrow, it'll be Sunday. And from Sunday, I have 11 more sleeps until I'm going to Thailand with Steve because he's taking me there for my 30th. And then 18 more sleeps until I turn 30. And I don't know why, I feel like everyone else feels massive anxiety around turning 30. Like, I almost, maybe it's just because I'm so busy that I haven't had time to comprehend the change, but I almost just don't really feel anything, but like to the extent that I don't even know if I feel excitement. I feel like I'm supposed to feel more nervous about it, but yeah, we'll see, maybe it'll hit me. One thing I would really like
turn left on Hanway Street, yeah. Then into
one thing I would really like to do for myself for my 30th is make myself feel pretty, because I feel like I've really let that slide over the last few months. So I'm gonna go get my hair done, get my nails done, get like a cute birthday outfit, maybe a couple bikinis or something, because I want to remember this day, and I'm spending it with the person I love in a different country, and that's really exciting. So I'm gonna look smoking while I do it,
or try to anyway.
Yay, I see it. Honestly, you get the cinnamon social slice, you won't regret it, and thank me later. I see my friend. You guys, this is an ASOS / New Balance event. We're here because we're on a 3K run and we're supposed to like get content on the event. I brought my plus one to get me loads of content.
That's what plus one's for.
She's a good plus one.
Let's go down the elevator.
That was really wholesome, and now I'm on my way to my mum's and I'm going to try and edit some content on the train home, and then hopefully my mum's going to feed us. Annoyingly, there are bus replacements on the one weekend that I'm coming home, and none of my family love me enough to pick me up, so
Also, I swear, we did run at that event. I just wasn't very good at getting enough content. Me and my friend just chatted the whole time.
Nicest way to say it is if you're not wearing your seatbelt, tough luck.
I feel a bit classic. Lovely, thank you for getting me.
Oh, I fucking hate bus replacements. How are you?
Yay, home sweet home. Having a brother is so good sometimes. Hi, mommy. Hello. You're cooking. Show us what you're making.
So, your favourite
potatoes.
Huh?
No. And what's in there?
And that's making niblets.
So excited.
Are you going to help me with a dessert in a minute? Because we might as well get it done.
Absolutely.
No nuts, just plain. Just sweet and soggy.
I'm just going to take the gals and show them my bedroom. Are you ready to see 15-year-old me's bedroom? Actually, my brother's kind of taken it over a little bit, so it is a bit of a shithole now, but...
Can you see baby Savannah sleeping in here?
Stole these stickers from a hospital, but that's another story for another day.
I'm so excited for lunch.
That's a really yummy lunch.
Yeah.
There you go.
The sink, please.
No.
Yes.
You guys, when I was a little girl, my mum used to make this dessert that I was obsessed with. Like, me and Sian used to have so much of it. And she's bought all the ingredients to teach me how to make it, which means we can learn how to make it together.
What's this called? Métisser. It's about boiling milk. Mm-hmm.
You're not
quite
sure,
are you? What, for what?
Yeah. When would you work on it?
Probably right, partner.
So, this is where I do
Then you put sugar.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of sugar. Seven, eight. It's 4 cups of coffee in there. Put a little saffron in the middle. Saffron's very strong, so you don't really need much. I'll put this back in the meantime. Can I have the scissors down, please? So just put what I've put there, a tablespoonful of
ghee.
Yeah, that's it. I'm doing it the recipe that you used to like when you were little, yeah?
Without nuts.
Okay, so that's done now. So just get this slightly warm.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit warm.
I'm excited. So to save yourself some time, the key is apparently to get the roasted vermicelli. Okay.
Can you turn it to 1, please? It's interesting how many people don't know what vermicelli is.
I didn't know before I met you.
It's like mini paschettis.
Yeah.
But thin spaghetti. You say, Mommy, can I have thin spaghetti? The sweet paschetti.
Sweet paschetti. Oh, I can smell the ghee.
And that's the smell that reminds you of home, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. And then you just pour it in, okay.
The people will be asking you about measurements, but I've never measured.
Indian mums don't measure.
Let it just boil for a couple of seconds and then...
Tastes like heaven.
Taste.
Mmm.
And you keep stirring because I don't want it to settle.
Yeah.
It's so good at cooking. Yum.
Look how thick she looks.
Oh! It's exactly the face you used to make me.
I'm so excited.
Oh my god. Mm. Oh my god.
Yeah. I cooked it. Oh, the suspense. Oh.
So good, right?
We're going to the pub.
Look at my eyes, oh my god. You can tell I've been away since 5:45, can't you?
I also haven't actually showered. Obviously getting ready in my mum's room because it's just generally cleaner than mine, but look how fire I look. And these slippers.
Thank you.
Dirt night in the middle of June.
Savannah.
Where's your watch?
Guess who didn't wake up on time and is now running late to get back to London? I hope you enjoyed spending a Saturday with my family and me, though. On the off chance that you did see this bad boy, I just wanted to let you guys know that there's absolutely nothing wrong with my health. I'm just hosting a little experiment on this bad boy, and I'm creating some content on it, so you'll find out about it soon. But I hope you have a great next week, and I'll bother you in next week's vlog.